Respected sir, I have four questions. First one is,
brother, please, hard to believe. Please mention your name and one question at a time.
Shijil. There are some hard to believe instances in any scriptures. For instance, in Quran, like birds dropping stones in a battlefield on the enemy's context like that, which is hard to believe. That's my first question.
That's the question. There are certain things mentioned in the Quran, like birds dropping stones, talking about Surah Fil, chapter number 105. There are many things. For example, Quran says about Shakkul Qamar, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam split the moon into two, Musa alayhi salam split the sea into two. These are difficult things, yes. These are known as miracles. Miracles are those things which a human mind cannot conceive how it happened. For us human being, to make the moon into two is not possible. For us human being to split the sea into two and have a pathway is not possible. So these are known as miracles, which only God can do, you and I cannot do. So it's difficult for us to conceive. The only way for us to testify is to go back into time. You're sitting now, we can't go back 3,000, 4,000 years back and check up whether Musa alayhi salam, Moses, did he split the sea or not. So what we say, these are miracles which doesn't allow us to go back in time. But there are many things which Quran has said, which has come to today. For example, Quran speaks about science, about the Big Bang. Quran speaks of the light of the moon, not its own light. Quran speaks the earth is spherical. Quran speaks the sun rotates, which to a man 1400 years back would sound, what is this nonsense? That the moon has its own light, that the earth is spherical, all these things about the Big Bang. But today, after science has advanced, we have come to know it's a fact. But to know what happened in the past, we can't go back in time. So what my logic says, whatever the Quran has mentioned, certain things we can check up now, certain things we can't check up. We can't go back in time. So that goes in the ambiguous lot. So what things we can check up today? Out of those things, whatever we can check up, say 80% things we can check up. So my logic says 80% of what the Quran mentioned, we can check up today, and we have come to 100% correct. Whatever we can check, not even 1% is wrong.
Most of the contents are historic, I think so.
Yes, that's what I'm telling you, brother. Historic. For you to say that thing didn't happen, you can only prove by going back in time. If the Quran says Prophet Moses split the sea, you can't prove that he didn't split. Neither can you prove he split. But we can't go back in time. Can we go back 3,000, 4,000 years back? Can we go? We can't. So what we say logically, this may have happened, may not have happened. May have happened, may not have happened. The birds may have dropped stone, may not have dropped stone. Correct? What we say, this is ambiguous. If we talk about the nuclear bomb, 1,000 years back, would they have believed? Would they have believed? They would have said this is nonsense, right or wrong. But today you and I believe or not? Because science is advanced. Similarly, there's nuclear bomb, there's atom bomb. So birds dropping stone, what's the problem? It is so easy. Nuclear bomb is more difficult. So here we realize we cannot go back in time. So what my logic says, whatever we can testify today, whatever we can analyze today, out of that, 100% has been proved to be correct. 20% we can't analyze, we cannot go back. We can't go in future. We cannot prove scientifically whether there's heaven or hell. So you'll ask me, Brother Zakir, you're a medical doctor. How do you believe in heaven and hell? I said that goes in the 20% ambiguous lot. So my logic says when 80% what we can check today of the Quran has been 100% to be correct, not even 0.1% is wrong. So my logic says what 20% is ambiguous, inshallah, God willing, even that will be correct. Maybe science will advance after 50 years, after 20 years, we'll come to know about life after death, we may come to know about heaven or hell. So my logic says it's a logical belief that when not even 0.0001% has been proved wrong of the Quran, 80% is 100% correct. So my logic says, inshallah, the 20% which you can't verify by going back in time or going in future, even that, inshallah, will be correct. Hope that answers the question.